Some of the high component will be turned to plus sign, so this fraction of incident power T transmitted to the surface is the total power of the wave at the surface of the transmitter side divided by the total incident power of the surface on the incident side. So we are just taking the ratio of these two powers. So after taking the ratio, so in order to do that thing, we are just considering this figure as a reference. So we are dealing with plane waves, and we are just applying the area for our purpose. And we just pretended we have square beams, and depth of incident and transmitted beam will be the same, but the width will be different because the refraction of the transmitted beam is spread out. So in order to calculate the ratio of width, we must relate it to width. Let them both by width. So we are relating the width WI and WT in terms of the transmitted and reflected angle, theta I and theta T. So WI is equal to W cos theta I, WT become W cos theta T. So here this is the reference figure. So we are just calculating WT and WI using this figure. So this is the argument that we are used for the calculation of WT and WI. So we were using Snell's law to get rid of the transmitted angle. So then A divided by A become like this, where N is the refracting index, N dash is the refracting index of this medium, and theta I's are the incident angle. So using this ratio, the transmission rate will become like this. We are just plugging the value into the equation of transmission, so we can directly get the transmission is like this. So after inserting the power densities, so we can just directly get the value of T is equal to nothing but in terms of N and N dash and U dash, and E0 and divided by E0. So E0 is the incident wave, E0 dash is the transmitted wave. So similarly, we can just calculate the power refracted like in this. So reflected power is nothing but P of R. The reflecting the R is defined in the reflected power divided by incident power at x equal to 0. So R is nothing but E0R divided by E0, the whole square. So we only compute the value of E0R and E0. So we can directly plug the E0R and E0 in this equation. So our R is like this. And here the polarization is perpendicular to the plane of incidence. So after expanding these things, we can. So this is the value of R. Similarly, we can just calculate the value of T. So the value of T will be like this. So if our electric field is parallel to the plane of incidence, then R can be written like this. So from that equation, we can just calculate R to be this, and the transmittivity T we can write like this. So in this problem, the material is non-magnetic, that is mu dash is mu, and we are at the normal incidence, like a theta I equal to 0. So we are just considering the normal incidence, and our incident material is in the free space, and that is n equal to 1 and n dash equal to n of omega. So plugging all these equations to there, so we can get the value of R and T in terms of N and in the second part of the question, we have to examine the rate of change of energy density. We have to take the dot product between E and D star and B and H star in order to calculate this thing. So we are defining D like we D is equal to epsilon E, epsilon is a function of omega, and omega B is nothing but K cross E, and H is nothing but 1 by E, B over mu zero. So then we are just plugging the value of those variables into these equations, and so here the incident wave is in this problem is transverse plane wave propagating normal to the material surface. So the transmitted wave must be also transverse plane wave propagating normal due to the symmetry. So we define like a z dimension as the normal. So we just consider z axis as normal and x axis as the polarization direction, and the electric field inside the material is like this. So we are just considering z axis as normal and x axis as polarization direction. So our electric field is like this. So we are just plugging the value of k omega to this equation. So we can also express these things in terms of imaginary part and real part. So from this equation, we can just calculate the magnitude of E square like to be this, and K cross E is like to be this. So we are using this equation in order to calculate E square and K cross E. So right now we have the values of E square, K cross E, and we also know the values of E from that equation. So we can directly plug those values to here. So after plugging those values, the values of E, D, K cross E, everything to here, our equation will be like this. So you have to do some simplification in order to get the final answer. So if you run this much also, you will get full score. So finally, we will express our energy density in terms of omega epsilon zero and the value of electric field transfer. So then we are calculating the power by unit area. In order to do that, we are just integrating our expression from 0 to infinity in the transfer to dz. So after integrating, you will get pt divided by pt over x. So after plugging these limiting values to the in your index order fraction is like this. So you can directly see that the 1.5 represents the index order fraction. So we can also express n in terms of skin depth. So using this formula, your n is changed like this. So right now we have the value of n. Right now we have the value of complex n. We already calculated the value of reflectivity and transmittivity in terms of n. We can directly put this value into this equation. So our reflectivity is changed like this. So it is a function of 1 plus i. But anyway, we are just taking the modulus square, it is always positive. And we are also so if you are using C by omega delta is very very less than 1, to simplify this, then your R is changed to 1 minus 2 delta omega over C, where delta is the skin depth, omega is angular frequency, and C is the velocity of light. Similarly, you can also calculate the transmittivity in terms of the complex index of reflection. So we are then, we need to plug the value of n to this equation. This is the value we calculated. So we are just putting this value to the equation of transmittivity, then which is changed to T is equal to 2 delta omega over C. So we can also calculate the change in energy density like this. We only need to plug the value of N to the energy density that we calculated before. So we can just define energy density like J dot E. So this is nothing but E star E. So we are just putting the value of E in this equation. Then finally we can express E in terms of the finally we can express all the value of N in terms of this complex refracting index. So finally you get the value of energy density is like this in terms of skin depth and omega. Also, the I also with the heat transmitter. So this match exactly the change in energy density, telling us that the limit of thick wood conductor of all the energy that is not reflected is close to Ohm's law. Both these expressions do not enter into the Poynting theorem because both express same energy loss. So, in order to solve this thing, initially